Hello everyone. Today let us know about the project Smart Studio. So let us extract the zipped file. You can see the file is extracting and you can see there is one more zipped file, that is Studio Automation. Let us extract this. And the file is extracting now and you can see that Studio Automation folder is created. Inside the folder, you have some files, that is DFT. DFT includes all the DFTs that is required for the documentation, and the complete project report is available and the project code. So open the project code. It includes all the PHP files which are required to execute the project. So let us copy this project code and let us paste this in C drive in XAMPP under htdocs folder. So let us paste this here. This is because I have installed XAMPP control panel in C drive. In whichever drive you have installed, search XAMPP in that particular folder and find htdocs and paste it there. Now let us rename the project name as Smart Studio. Now let us open XAMPP control panel. The XAMPP control panel is required to execute the PHP program. So let us start Apache MySQL server, and you can see that it is running now. Now let us copy the name of the file Smart Studio, because we are using this name itself to execute the program. So let us open the browser and type localhost slash and paste the name of the folder which you have copied. So you can see that there is some connection error, that is unknown database Smart Studio. Localhost slash php myadmin will open the MySQL database. This is a MySQL server, and clicking on databases you can create the database. The database name should be same as the database SQL file whatever you have. Click on import to import the database file. Click on choose file. And in the choose file in Smart Studio, you have a backup folder. In that folder, you can find the Smart Studio SQL file. Import the file and click on go. This might take some time. And once the database is imported, you can use all the tables that are present in that database. Now clicking on refresh, the database is refreshed and you can see there are no more errors. Smart Studio is a project which is designed to set up the online studio where a customers can browse through the studio and the system administrator to maintain the setup. Here the customers can order t-shirts, mugs, albums, photo calendars, etc. online, and they can also customize it. The admin is the one who handles the entire website. Now let us log in as the employee or the admin. The admin can log in using the login ID and the password. As the admin logs in, the admin dashboard is available, which includes all the records. In accounts under admin profile, the admin can update his profile, and in change password, the admin can make changes to their password by mentioning old, new and confirm password. In view customers, here the admin can view the customers who are registered in the portal. And admin can also edit or delete the customer details. In add employee, here the admin can add the employees for the web page, and here these employees will handle the web page. And there is employee type, either employee or admin. You can see that the login ID must include only the alphabet. This is the validation which is used for the form. Once the employee record is inserted, it can be viewed under view employee. So here again the admin has the action delete or edit, where he can delete or edit the employee details. In calendar, under add calendar, here the admin will add the different types of calendars available and the image of that particular calendar, the size of the calendar, cost of the calendar, and the description about the calendar must be entered. And on selecting active, the calendar record will be inserted and this can be viewed also, and there is edit option, and this is available for all the months. In view calendar, here the admin can view the entire records, that is different types of calendars which is available in their particular shop. In mug, here also the admin can add the different types of mugs with the images and the cost, color, and the descriptions, and this can be viewed under view mug. So the different types of mugs, that is coffee mugs, glass mug, and it is available in different colors. And the t-shirts, here the different t-shirts are available and the images of the t-shirt is put up, and the t-shirt designer is also put up. Along with that, the cost, color, size, and description must be mentioned. So here the customers can order these t-shirts and they can also customize it. Different photo edited t-shirts are available. And in album, under add album, the different types of albums are added by the admin. And along with that, the size and the cost also is added. And the different albums can be viewed under view album, and the first page, inner page, and back page can also be published. And in photo frame, here you can see the type of the photo frame must be mentioned. So let us take it as circle, and the frame category must be selected, and the image must be posted. That is to understand the customer that this is the type of the frame available. And the designer of the frame also must be posted. The size of the frame, the cost of the frame, and the description of the frame must be entered. On clicking on click here to insert, the frame will be inserted and this can be viewed under view photo frame. And the admin has the action to edit or delete these details. In offer, the admin can view the various offers available for different types of items, and the status must be changed here. If it is active, then the discount is available. Inactive means discount is not available. And the pending orders can be viewed. Along with that, processing orders, delivery processing, and delivered orders can be viewed by the admin. So you can see that this order is delivered and there are other orders which are yet to be delivered. So now let us log out from admin. Now let us register as the customer. The customer is the most essential part of the web page, because without the customer, the transaction doesn't happen. The customer must register using his name, mobile number, email ID, password, and the confirm password. So on click here to register, the customer's record will be inserted to the database and the login page is available for the customer. Here he must mention the login ID and password. But in case if the customer forgets the password, there is an option, did you forget password? And here the customer must mention the email ID. And on mentioning the valid email ID and clicking on click here to recover password, the link will be sent to the mail on which he can recover the password. And on mentioning the email ID and the password, the customer must log in. Once the customer logs in, they can buy any of the products. On clicking on view more, they can view the product in detail and they can click on start designing. That is, the customer must mention what is the image and what is the text he need in the cup what he has chosen. So on clicking on upload image, the different images must be selected that which he wanted in the mug, and the text also must be mentioned. The text and the image will be confirmed and the order will be confirmed. On checkout, the note must be written, that is, here the customer can mention the date on which he need the product or any other necessary details can be mentioned, and then the delivery address must be mentioned, where the address, city and pin code is required, and in the payment panel, payment type, card holder name, card number, expiry date and the CVV number must be required. On clicking on click here to make payment, payment will be done successfully and the bill receipt is generated, which includes the bill amount and the offered discount. In the account in profile, here the customer can make changes to their profile details, and in change password, the password can be changed by mentioning old, new and confirm password. Under order report, in view pending orders, the customer can view the order made by them which is in pending, which is not delivered at, and the bill receipt can also be viewed. And now let us log out as the customer. Let us log in as admin again. The admin will log in using the login ID and password, and as he logs in, the dashboard is available. Under order report, in view pending orders, we can see the order which we made currently, that is in pending, and on viewing it, you can see that the payment is made and there is order status, where the order status is currently pending. And update order status, here on clicking on process and under update order status, here now under report in view processing orders, you can see that particular customer's details and the status is process now. The admin can update the order status for delivery process, that is the next stage. And on updating in order report under view delivery process orders, here the customer's details can be viewed and the tracking detail is delivery process. The last stage is order status delivered. On updating order status delivered, the admin can view the order status as delivered under view delivered orders. So under view delivered orders, you can see that the order made by the customer is delivered now. So let us log out as the admin now. Now let us log in as the customer and let us see the order status now. The customer will log in using the email ID and the password. In the customer account, under order report, in view ordered, in view delivered order, you can see the order status is delivered, and on viewing the bill can be viewed. And this is how the Smart Studio project works. So this is about the project Smart Studio, where the customized products are available. for the customers. And thank you for watching the video. For further queries, kindly visit our website. Thank you.